So, been doing some hauling and just moving things around with my truck. My Cummins, that is, the crew cab. And I've got my stacks, which I absolutely love. These are just the coolest things on this truck. Especially with the Cummins. You know, injection pump's turned up a little bit, so it blows some extra black smoke. And it's just awesome and absolutely ridiculous. But that comboed with my toolbox that pushes my toolbox back, what is it, 6-7 inches or so, makes my short bed truck, which I'm only working with 6.5 feet anyways, cuts this thing down to like 4 feet. And I have no room to put anything in this truck. So, time to make a grown-up decision. I think it's time to lose the stacks. So, I've got the exhaust off of my 89 still, which was my parts truck for this one. It was straight pipe system. I used part of it on this, but I didn't end up using the tailpipe section, which is what I have here. So, I have the tailpipe, it goes up and over the axle, and it turns out the side here. And so I think I'm going to try to put this back on, because this is pretty much the exact same frame as the 89. All the mounts that were on that old exhaust line up pretty good with everything that's here. So it should pretty much bolt on, or be about as close to a bolt-on exhaust system as you can get. And that'll free up my bed. And then I've got a couple different toolboxes. I mean, I do like the toolbox for extra storage and things like that, but I may end up losing the toolbox as well, just because this truck is kind of my everyday, kind of all-around vehicle now. It's, being the short bed, I need the space just to even haul the most basic things. So, yeah, get this changed up, and hopefully it'll sound pretty good. That was the other thing I liked about the stacks. I had the motor up front makes so much noise. Those mechanical 12 valves are just so noisy. And then I don't have hardly any insulation in the cab. I can't hear the exhaust when it's back here. I couldn't in the 89 at least, and I'm sure I won't in this one. And so it was cool having them behind your head, because you could hear it, have the window roll down. And just when you roll into the throttle from kind of, you know, a slow start or even a dead stop, and just that initial grumble is just so cool. But like I said, I gotta make some grown-up decisions, so we'll get this changed. Like it's just not put on right, so I might have to straighten that out, make it look a little better. But it's just a couple clamps with the hangers holding it, so I can loosen them up, rotate it, do what I want. I did end up ordering an exhaust tip for this, so just go to a 5-inch tip, nothing special, just black 5-inch tip. So I'll put that on, I'll play with it, see how it looks after that. But yeah, Vic, now I can at least use my bed. So, 6-foot bed now, definitely needs cleaned out. A lot of crap in here. But the truck is now, you know, usable again. So, kind of weird. Looks kind of naked. But I do like these crew cabs, especially a short bed four-wheel drive. The proportions of them are pretty cool. They almost look clean and pretty neat without anything in the bed. But I think I will put my toolbox back in. I'll see, because I can at least move it forward now. And yeah, hopefully I have, you know, that 6 inches at least back in space. So, and that'll help kind of fill in space-wise, make it look not so naked back there. But yeah, I'm happy with it. That should work for now. I'm sure this is definitely not the final rendition of the old crew cab, so. But that'll work for now. Till next time.